Hey guys, Joe from Eastwood. In this video, we're gonna be taking a closer look at what you'll wanna consider for welding safety. You wanna make sure you have all your safety gear in order beforehand because, as we all know, welding arcs are obviously super dangerous. They're very hot, unbelievably bright. They give off infrared and UV radiation as well as dangerous fumes. So safety is gonna be very important. You'll need to consider what clothes to wear, what gear you'll need, what helmet and how to make sure it's functioning properly, what respirator you'll need to protect your lungs, and what fire extinguisher you'll want to keep around for welding. All right, so before we even actually start welding, there's already some danger while getting everything set up. Most of that is going to come down to the gas bottle. Now, the pressure in these gas bottles is very high, upwards of 2000 PSI. If one of these falls over and the valve breaks, you basically have an air-powered torpedo on your hands. When you're bringing home a full bottle, always keep the safety cap on until you get it secured to your cart with a safety chain. Always keep these things stored upright at all times. Open the valve slowly and just check for leaks or anything out of the ordinary before getting started. And these things are pretty heavy too, so you don't want them to fall over and crush your toes either. Now, another thing you'll want to consider is the environment that you're welding in. For fumes, make sure you're in a well-ventilated area. Open your garage door. You just want enough air circulation to be able to breathe clean air, but not so much to blow the shielding gas off of your weld. Also, make sure that there's nothing around that's obviously flammable. No oil leaks or sawdust on the ground, that type of thing. If you have something you don't want to get hit with sparks, a fiberglass welding blanket like this one is easy to just throw over top of it in order to protect it. Again, there's gonna be sparks, so just keep that in mind. Also, if you have family members or friends around, it's a good idea to set up a shield just in case anyone walks in. You do not want to flash them. Next up, let's talk about clothing. Again, there's gonna be very hot sparks coming off of the weld. So you do wanna cover your skin with a non-flammable material like a non-flammable cotton, Kevlar, or a leather. You want a good pair of jeans, no fashion stuff. Those little frays on the fake rips in the knees or fake frays at the bottom of your pant leg are just a little bit of kindling and they catch on fire really easily. So just get a good pair of work jeans from a good brand. Also, be sure to unroll any cuffs and pull your pant leg over your shoes to prevent spatter from landing in your boot. Speaking about boots, you'll also need some closed-toed leather shoes. Closed-toe leather boots are a must-have. You wanna make sure you have a steel toe if you're working in the field, but that's always a good thing to have, even if you're just working in the garage. Keep that in mind when you buy a pair. As far as your shirt goes, it doesn't really matter. Long sleeves are a good idea, but the jacket is gonna cover you anyways. Just be sure to tuck in any chains, remove any jewelry, and of course, make sure all your clothes have a nice tight fit. You don't want anything loose while you're welding. Now, let's move along to the safety gear. The first thing you need is a helmet. Now, these are impact rated. They'll keep the sparks off your face and protect your eyes. And of course, they'll allow you to see. I'd obviously recommend going with an auto darkening helmet. That's just the standard nowadays. Even when these are undarkened, they'll give you 100% IR and UV protection. And they darken in, not kidding here, a tenth of a millisecond. So we're literally talking about microseconds after starting an arc. Pretty fascinating stuff. Any welding helmet you get is going to be able to do at least a shade 10. That's as low as I'll ever go personally. As you turn up the amps, turn that shade up to compensate. All the helmets go up to at least a 12. Most of them go up to a shade 13. Now, I always like to test my helmets by striking a lighter in front of my helmet before I get going. That's a good test to make sure your shade is darkening correctly. You don't want to get a flash because one of your button cell batteries was dead and your solar panel wasn't charged up for some reason. So I always test. That's important to me personally. That brings us to our jacket. Very important for MIG or arc welding. When you get a lot of spatter flying off, one of these is going to protect you. Those little BBs of spatter are very hot. A good jacket will go a long way. Make sure it's made of a non-flammable material. Again, cotton, Kevlar, or leather. This will protect you, and it'll keep you from getting a suntan as welding produces UV and IR radiation, which are both always good to try to avoid. You'll need some gloves too. Kid skin is nice. Just keep in mind, TIG gloves tend to be a little bit thinner for the added dexterity you need for feeding wire, but for MIG, you don't need that, so go with the thicker gloves for extra protection. I also recommend a respirator. You don't need anything crazier than a P100 rated 2091 pancake style filter like you see right here. Breathing in these gases for a long time is dangerous, and the first time you weld, everything will smell like sweaty nickels for a few hours afterward. I've been called a wuss for wearing one of these under my helmet, but the way I see it is there are some lessons in life you don't even get the chance to learn the easy way. I think lung safety falls into that category, so I'll always recommend just wearing one. Same thing goes for safety glasses as well. A lot of people wear these under their hood. Reason for that is it's only instinct to want to lift up your helmet and inspect your weld as soon as you end your arc. If that weld pops while it's cooling down for some reason and shoots something out of it in your face while your face is right there next to the weld, it's going to be a bad day for you for sure. Most safety goggles also provide UV and IR protection too, even the clear ones. So that's another layer of protection that is just worth having. You can check if your safety goggles protect from UV and IR very easily. There'll be a U for UV on the arm and an R for IR also printed on the arm. Lastly, a fire extinguisher is a no-brainer, but it's always a good thing to have close by. Get an ABC monoammonium phosphate extinguisher. This will cover you for pretty much everything you'd run into while welding, and you can pick one up for less than $100, and that's always money well spent. Press the button to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We're giving away a MIG 180 welder at 500,000 subscribers. Make sure you check out our channel too. We post tons of great how-to content and product videos over there. We'll have all the products you see linked down below. And as always, guys, thank you so much for watching. I'm Joe. Make sure you keep it right here at Eastwood to do the job right.